Well, hand sanitizer, of course. And there are also these thermometer cards here. It allows the kids to take their own temperature. And on the back, there's the symptoms for cold and flu. It's just another way of bringing awareness.
Five students sick Tuesday and one the day before. Those at Phillips Exeter Academy are taking it seriously, suspecting it may be H1N1.
There doesn't seem to be any surprise that we have gotten cases of the flu. We expected it. We've educated the students. We've gotten them ready. We have contingency plans. And so I don't think there's any sense of panic.
The private school students are being treated in the Health and Wellness Center on campus, and samples have been sent to the state for testing. The state won't test for every possible H1N1 case, but since the school year just began, Health and Human Services wants to confirm the virus is out there. In the meantime, Phillips Exeter is getting the message out with letters, signs, and plenty of hand sanitizer, in many cases just inches from workplaces.
We've asked day school parents if their children are sick to keep them home, of course. We've asked parents that live within a driving distance if they would come and pick up their kids and take them home.
At UNH, the message is similar. Students who live in a 250-mile radius of campus can go home if they get sick, and those in the dorms can self-isolate, even with a roommate.
There doesn't need to be isolation in terms of being removed from people. What we're saying is that we provide them guidelines to basically take care of themselves and their roommates, which includes, of course, limiting their activity, basically try not to get close to other people. If they do need to be in contact with others, to wear a mask.
The university has had some students complain of cold and flu-like symptoms, but so far no confirmed cases of H1N1. Both UNH and Phillips Exeter are two of the 72 schools reporting to the state.
Certainly we would like to get 100% of the schools reporting. We cannot really give the general public or even the schools a really good picture and help if they are not part of the system and reporting regularly to us.
Now, of the 72 schools reporting, Dr. Montero says that very few have said that some of the students have flu-like symptoms, but obviously that's subject to change every day. Reporting live in the newsroom, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.